take a deeper dive into how to best set up our Brownie development environment to work with one of the world's most popular L2s, Polygon. Polygon is fast, Polygon is cheap, Polygon has a ton of users and applications on top of it. But if you want to develop against it, we're going to want to do a few changes to our Brownie instance. For starters, we're going to be using Alchemy instead of Infura. Infura is great. Alchemy also similarly has a free developer tier, but this one includes the capability of forking the Polygon mainnet. It also has an archive node in their free tier. So I've copied the RPC node. And as a bit of a refresher, I'm going to type Brownie Networks help. And you can see I've deleted previously all the Polygon instances I have. So I just want to add like it has set up here. Go ahead and type Brownie Networks add. I'm going to add this under the environment of Polygon with the name, the ID that it'll call in the command line is Polygon. The host I'm going to set equal to that RPC node. And then I have a environment variable Web3 Alchemy project ID. I'm also going to set up the chain ID as 137. The name I'm going to set to Polygon. And I'd like to have the Explorer to be able to fetch the contract source. I'm going to use Polygon Scans API. And you're going to want to make sure that you have set up your Polygon Scan key. Otherwise, you're going to get a lot of rate limits. So I now have a Polygon Let's type this in and see if this works. So off the bat, it looks like I'm connecting. That's really good news. Let's make sure this passes the sniff test. I'm looking at Polygon Scan, and I can take a look at the top accounts and see that currently the Matic token is unsurprisingly mostly sitting in the Matic address 1010. And we'll just check the balance of this one. And this matches up, 9229. Looks good. We also run network.showActive, but this is just going to show the ID. So if I set something up wrong, I wouldn't know. All right, so far so good. Next up, I'd like to be able to add a Polygon fork. And in this case, I'm just gonna basically copy the parameters of the mainnet fork. And in fact, I mostly advise that you do this directly within editing the .brownie network config. It's under .brownie networks.yaml. If you want to do it in the command line, you can do it too. You just need to make sure that you add all these parameters. So you want brownie networks add development. It has to be development in this case because development doesn't need to pass some of these things like chain ID. We're going to use Polygon fork. The host is going to be set to localhost. Command that we'll run is copying this ganache CLI. And that fork is going to be set to Polygon instead of mainnet. Other than that, we'll copy all these other settings. We'd like to have a timeout equal to 120, accounts equals 10. EVM version equals Istanbul, gas limit equals 12000000, mnemonic equals brownie, and port equals 8545. So it says it's added. But let's take it for a spin and make sure this is the case. All right, so far so good. So let's take a look at a couple of things next. Gonna take a look at the curve address provider. I'm getting this address off of Etherscan, but it should be the same off of every different network. And in fact, it looks like it's got it. Let's use this to load up the curve registry. And we should note that the Polygon registry will hopefully be a bit different than the registry that we'd see elsewhere. If I type this address in, we in fact see there is a contract there. So that's a good sign. And it is in fact the Curve Polygon registry. So far, so good. One last thing that we'd like to take a look at is we don't have the capability of using Brownie Token Tester out of the box on this. Brownie Token Tester relies on Explorer to pull leaderboards. We'll show you the same concept that they do. So if you need to get some tokens to play with on Polygon mainnet, or rather the Polygon fork, here's how you can do it. So now that we have the registry, let's take a look at the very first coin. And I'm going to assign this to a coin. And this happens to be, It would help if I make an actual contract. Coin.name is Ovmatic Market DAI, okay? Let's take a quick look at Polygon scan and see what this coin is. And on Polygon scan, you can see the top holders page after it loads. So when you're using Brownie Token Tester, with some tokens, what it's doing is it's just you looking at the leaderboards and transferring funds from the top address to you. So let's see if this person is going to be so nice. Our whale has been set up. And let's just confirm that coin balance of accounts zero is in fact nothing. Now let's go ahead and transfer to accounts zero from the amount of 10 times coin.decimals from our whale. And it's going to think, and it's going to connect to the node, and it's going to do whatever magic it needs to. And now we see that we have some funds to play with. So you might try automating this. Maybe you can stick the whale address in to like a script locally and call it. And if you're seeing your test fail because maybe that whale moved its funds, just replace the whale address. It's basically the same concept. I'm sure at some point someone's going to invent a reliable Polygon leaderboard API that could be used to integrate, and we can have a Polygon token tester. Until then, this should get you up and running. Hope this is everything you need. Feel free to drop questions in the comments.